Saw the news yesterday. I don't know if it's news. Saw the opinion yesterday, report from Dan Patrick yesterday, that Tennessee had been paying players in McDonald's bags. Did you guys see that? Got a lot of attention yesterday on the DP show, which obviously will be on after this show on many of our affiliate stations across the country. And my immediate thought, 100%, I'm going to be honest with you, was there's no way that report is true, because there's no way any Southern school worth its salt would pay players inside of McDonald's bags if they're going to give money
quarter pound
to
of
anybody.
The cheese?
No. Don't. It would be inside of a Chick-fil-A bag. And you guys may think that this is funny, but I would almost put $100,000 if I had to bet on it. If there was any bag being used in a fast food restaurant to pay players, it would be a Chick-fil-A bag. Because, let me just tell you this, every school in the South is got players that are obsessed with Chick-fil-A. And there are a lot of you out there listening right now like, well, I just decided what I'm going to get for lunch. Or you're driving to work and you just made a U-turn and you're like, I got to go get a chicken biscuit. Well, Clay mentioned Chick-fil-A. That sounds awfully good this morning. Here I go to Chick-fil-A drive-thru. By the way, I also think Chick-fil-A should be in charge of distributing all the COVID vaccine, because if you've ever been through one of their drive-thrus, it's the most efficient process known to man. But I say this. The reason why they wouldn't get McDonald's is because, one, I have seen Chick-fil-A distributed right after games at almost every different SEC school in the entire country, right? You finish the game and you walk outside of your locker room on Saturday and there is a huge stack of Chick-fil-A for every player as their post-game meal. Why do they do that? Because you don't have to worry about what somebody wants on their Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich like you would if you're ordering somebody a hamburger. And this sounds simple, but it's why I don't believe the McDonald's story. Because if you want a hamburger, does somebody want onions? Do they want ketchup? Do they want mustard? Do they want a tomato? Do they want lettuce? Do they want cheese or not? Everybody's hamburger order is by and large very specific. And there are a lot of you out there right now who are picky enough. You're like, oh, that hamburger's got onions? Yeah, I don't want it. Oh, that there's ketchup and mustard and mayo? I only like ketchup, right? Whatever you like on your hamburger, you might not be willing to eat a hamburger otherwise. Chick-fil-A, boom, the Chick-fil-A sandwich, the only thing you don't want on there is the pickle.
Yeah, that's what
that's easy to remove,
yeah.
And you eat it. So I would love to hear Dan Patrick explain why any Southern school worth its salt would go with McDonald's bags to give players money when they could have gone with Chick-fil-A bags to give players money, because the players actually want Chick-fil-A, and presumably when you're giving players money on visits, they're going to take a bag from a fast food restaurant that they 100% would eat. I would wager almost every dollar that I have that if there is money being paid, and a lot of people had fun with the McDonald's angle, it would be coming from Chick-fil-A. So that when I heard the report, I was like, oh, it's interesting. I definitely don't dispute that people get paid on every college campus in America that is trying to win championships. Power Five schools, basketball, and for football, guys are getting paid left and right. So this idea that's out there that guys are not getting paid, or, oh, your school is holier than thou and everything else. No, schools are getting paid. Now, the interesting thing about the Jeremy Pruitt angle to me is I thought Chad Withrow made a good analogy when we had him on. I think it was yesterday, right? He said this would be like deciding you need to remodel your kitchen and burning the whole house down with the way that Tennessee conducts investigations. And I do think that's intriguing in the grand scheme of things. Why in the world does Tennessee almost uniquely do these investigations and end up firing their coaches? Because they did it, and you can say, well, Jeremy Pruitt's not a very good coach. Tennessee did this to Bruce Pearl, and I think Bruce Pearl is one of the 10 best college basketball coaches in America. I think if Tennessee hadn't fired Bruce Pearl, he may have won a national championship for the Vols by now. We know he's already taken Auburn to the Final Four, and he almost beat UVA, the team that went on and ended up winning their championship. What feels like, by the way, a very long time ago now, because we didn't have an NCAA tournament last year. It's been almost 2 years. By the way, did you see the story? The NCAA tournament, yesterday they came out with news. They are moving the NCAA tournament. Usually, if you are out there listening to us, the NCAA tournament usually opens on a Thursday. They are now starting the NCAA tournament on a Friday. I mean the big tournament. So instead of it being a Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday of opening weekend, it's now going to be a Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. So some of you are going to need to get sick and stay sick from Friday all the way till Monday in order to be able to stay out of work and watch the NCAA tournament. I don't necessarily know why that move is being made. It seems like a wacky move to me. I think they've decided to put the first four, you know, the four games that they typically are playing on Tuesday and Wednesday, I think they're playing all of them on Thursday, is my understanding, looking at the breakdown. But there are going to be a lot of people out there surprised about the Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, as opposed to Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. But the larger context here in which I'm talking about is everybody out there conducts investigations off and on. I'm not sure why every time Tennessee catches itself, it treats it like they're the only school that's cheating anywhere in the country. And they've done it with a good coach in Bruce Pearl now and a bad coach in Jeremy Pruitt, both of whom were fired effectively for cause without having to pay any money at all. Now, the Tennessee basketball program's in pretty good shape. They got Rick Barnes, although they got run last night by the Florida Gators. They're in the mix. You know, they were a 2 seed a couple of years ago. They're in the mix to win and contend in the SEC pretty much every other year or so with Rick Barnes. Things are going pretty well with the Tennessee basketball program, which proves that really all you need to do is go find a decent head coach and they can put everything back in order, which brings me to a larger context here. There are a lot of head coaches that want this Tennessee job. I have heard personally from 5 different coaches that everybody out there would know wanting to talk about the Tennessee job and express their interest in it. And I'm not sure exactly which direction Tennessee is going to go. I think they're going to have to make a choice about the athletic director first. But there are a lot of people out there interested. This job, there's decent talent on the roster. The expectations are relatively low. And the fact that Tennessee has decided to come forward with every single thing, in theory, from their investigation means the expectation is the NCAA is not going to take a pound of flesh given the fact that Tennessee has already fired so many different people. But it is interesting when you look at a school like LSU with head basketball coach Will Wade, which basically stuck up the middle finger in the NCAA's direction and said, hey, we're not going to comply in any way here. Remember that long investigation that the FBI got involved in, all those wiretaps and everything else, they haven't even resolved what the penalties are going to be for all of the schools involved in that investigation. And it's now been almost 4 years since that story broke. Meanwhile, whether it's Arizona, whether it's Kansas, whether it's LSU, whether it's Auburn, like all that stuff is still being resolved now. And it's been almost 4 years. And the schools that have refused to comply with the NCAA haven't had any sort of significant consequences. Meanwhile, Tennessee has got NCAA investigators sitting in on their Zoom calls when they're conducting their interviews with the head coach, Jeremy Pruitt, and others. And to me, that means that the ultimate punishment is not going to be very severe in the grand scheme of things. We'll get to that a bit in a moment. I'll bring in the crew. But first, Eddie Garcia, what you got for me?
Well, we start with news from Major League Baseball, where the Toronto Blue Jays and free agent outfielder George Springer reportedly agree on a 6-year, $150 million contract. That would be the largest contract ever given out in Blue Jays history. Springer's a 3-time All-Star and was named World Series MVP while with the Astros in 2017. As expected, the New York Mets fired GM Jared Porter Tuesday morning. He acknowledged sending explicit and unsolicited texts and images to a female reporter when he worked for the Cubs back in 2016. He was just hired by the Mets as their GM back in December. Just two games in the NBA. Nuggets over the Thunder, 119-101. Jazz beat the Pelicans, 118-102. College basketball, number 3, Villanova gets by Seton Hall, 76-74. Seventh-ranked Michigan, a big win over Maryland, 87-63. Florida with the upset of the night, beating number 6, Tennessee, 75-49. And Purdue on a late three-pointer gets by number 15, Ohio State, 67-65. Wins in the top 25 for number 18, Alabama, number 19, Missouri, and number 22, Illinois. Back to Outkick the coverage in a second, but first, a word from Farmers.
Call 1-888-FARMERS and you could save on your auto insurance. It's better than using your phone to see if your post got any likes again. Call 1-888-FARMERS to get a quote.
We are Farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Underwritten by Farmers, Truck, Fire Insurance, Exchanges, or Affiliate. Products not available in every state.
Now back to Clay Travis and the Farmers Outkick the Coverage Studios.
All right, we're rolling through all this. Let me bring in the crew. I'm going to start with Dub because you actually went to an SEC school. When you heard the McDonald's story and the SEC allegation, did you have a reaction like me and think there's no way this is true? It had to be Chick-fil-A if they were actually doing this?
Well, I had a kind of a joint reaction. I thought, first of all, this is very likely possible, if not true.
Yes.
Every SEC school does this. You know, the backdoor
players, when the allegation is that they paid them, gave them money when they came to campus. And so I'm with you in that I think if they basically all are paying players, all right? Like, let's stop pretending like, oh, my God, like, don't grab your pearls and fall on the fainting couch. Like, all of these guys. I mean, when I saw that Creighton basketball was alleged to have been paying players as part of that FBI investigation, if I remember correctly, if Creighton is allegedly paying some guy six figures to come play basketball in Omaha, Nebraska, and you're telling me everybody else isn't doing it for bigger programs for basketball, not to mention football, I mean, you're insane. So, yes, everybody's getting money. It's why I think the NCAA is oftentimes so much of a sham. But, okay, I cut you off there, but I was when the McDonald's story came out, did you have my Chick-fil-A reaction as well?
Yeah, and this whole thing, it's funny because you could – you know, pick a region of the country and the paper bag would change, right? So in like the West Coast or in Texas, it would probably be a Whataburger bag. In the South, it's a Chick-fil-A bag, and you go on from there. So yeah, it's pretty good.
Danny G, do you buy in that if they were paying players, it was not McDonald's bags, it was much more likely to be Chick-fil-A bags?
Well, the thing I thought about was maybe a Chick-fil-A bag would cause too much attention. Whereas the McDonald's bag is kind of on the low. Like, in other words, if I see somebody walk into a room with a Chick-fil-A bag,
you notice it because you're like, oh, that looks good.
Hell yeah, grabs my attention. I wonder what they ordered. Did they get a couple extra packs of the original sauce, which is my favorite? If somebody walks in with a McDonald's bag, I don't even pay attention to that.
Yeah, thanks. McDonald's now never spending a dollar with the show going forward.
Well, I didn't say
that.
I didn't say their food wasn't good.
$8 million advertising contract. You just blew it up.
It's not that their food isn't good. It's that it's so run of the mill. Like, I'm used to that ever since a little kid. I just got a Chick-fil-A in Burbank finally 2 years ago, so that's special.
What about you, Eddie? Do you think that they would be paying players in McDonald's bags, or are they going Chick-fil-A?
Well, I mean, everything I've heard of is, I mean, Chick-fil-A here is still kind of a special thing. It's not everywhere. And matter of fact, we're supposed to get one where I live, and I've been waiting for it to finally open up.
But yeah,
I would say Chick-fil-A makes too much sense.
You love it, Eddie. It's got pickles.
No, I don't like the pickles, but everything
I'll tell you this. I just don't buy, like, because it's not only that I know directly all of the different teams. Like, if you walk in the tunnel after a game, the number of teams that just have Chick-fil-A lined up, because I've wanted to take it myself, for their players is off the charts. So they're definitely, if they're going to give them, you know, like snacks and meal, they're going to go with the Chick-fil-A sandwich as the way that they convey things. Now, whether or not there are dollars inside of that bag or not, I mean, it wouldn't really surprise me. I do think it's interesting. Can you guys remember any other school that seems as eager to catch itself cheating as Tennessee? Like, I'm going to open up the phone lines for this too, 877-996-6369. I mean, if you go back over the last decade, Tennessee with Bruce Pearl and now this with Jeremy Pruitt, Tennessee seems so incredibly eager to catch itself cheating. And other schools, and I'll use LSU as an example, just seem to throw up the double middle fingers to the NCAA and say, we dare you to do anything. And Tennessee is like, oh my goodness, we're falling on our knees. We feel so incredibly awful about what we've done. NCAA, can you please forgive us? What do you need from us? We're rending our garments. We're crawling around wailing on the phone. Can anybody else remember a school that is more eager? That's why I think the analogy is interesting. You're like, okay, this Jeremy Pruitt hire may not work out. Let's go ahead and remodel the kitchen. And then they just decide to burn down the whole house. Now, I do think in the end result here, they're going to save a decent amount of money because I don't think Jeremy Pruitt's going to get any money based on the wrongdoing that was going here. And so Tennessee's got significant money to spend to go hire a new coach, which is why I think there's substantial interest out there. But by and large, can you guys think of any other team that does this, that has done an internal investigation and just kind of throws itself? And, you know, some people out there are going to say, well, this is because they didn't want to pay Jeremy Pruitt, and that was the impetus for this. And I might agree with that on some level if we hadn't already seen it with Bruce Pearl. And by the way, it also happened with Donnie Tindall, another coach that they brought in. They did their own investigation and ended up kicking him to the curb too. So, I mean, these are three different coaches that they have fired for cause in the space of a decade. And I can't think of hardly any other program out there that has fired more than one coach for cause. And most schools haven't even done that. And Tennessee now has done three different coaches where they haven't given anything.